Real quickly, let's break down some RHONY rumors. Let's do the rumor meal with RHONY, Real Housewives of New York. So it's being speculated that there will be a big Real Houses of New York announcement at next month's BravoCon. It seems like they've wrapped filming for the reboot, or at least are coming to a conclusion with filming for the reboot. But there's a rumor going around that the execs aren't really happy with the reboot, and they're not thrilled by the footage or by the cast of women, which I think makes sense because the whole announcement was just so premature. Like, you announced a show before you even began casting for it. Then you said that you were doing Legacy before that was even cast. Like, I just felt like those announcements came way too early and they had no idea what they were actually going to do with either of these shows or with Real Houses of New York altogether. So it does seem like they've wrapped for the reboot. So the casting has been done. I don't know. I've said I'm not interested. Julia Fox has come out and she said that she was talking to producers about doing the show, but that ultimately she's not going to do the show because if she were ever to do it, it would have to be a group of her actual friends and not just a cast women of, you know, that are in New York. It seems like they're casting a lot of like Instagram influencers. And from what I know of this world of influencers, especially the Instagram ones, they're usually not that very entertaining. They're not very good. It's like Busy Phillips, right? Busy Phillips was great on Instagram stories, but when we finally gave her own talk show, she wasn't great at that. Like, it wasn't her natural forum. So I think with Instagram models, it's kind of the same thing. Like, one, they're really boring. That's why they're pretty, because they don't have a personality. And two, if they do have a personality, like, you have to make sure people mesh. Like, I don't know. I'm not looking forward to it. I would have looked forward to it if they had brought in Julia Fox. I actually wouldn't have even hated it if they brought in Julia Fox and Leah McSweeney, because I know people hate Leah, but I think she can be really interesting in the right group and cast of women. Curious to see what she brings in Ultimate Girls Trip Season 3. I know Whitney Rose just did a podcast interview where she talked about Ultimate Girls Trip Season 3. She says that Leah is definitely the lightning rod. There were a lot of things she revealed about it, and she revealed about the new season of Real Houses of Salt Lake City. I cannot remember for the life of me what podcast she did it on, but I know she just did an interview, and I believe Queens of Bravo was the one that recapped it, so you might want to check out Queens of Bravo, and they might have that full recap. Maybe I'll break it down further in Wednesday's episode of the podcast, but yeah, I assume that they're going to have an announcement at BravoCon. BravoCon just seems like it would be the most appropriate place to have an announcement. And I feel like they don't have much that they could really announce in this moment. And the biggest announcement that they can make will have to be in reference to Real Housewives of New York, because RHONY's the biggest thing that they can address at BravoCon right now, because it's the one thing that's kind of just like left up in the air that's uncertain. So I know Lu and Sonja they have their small town spinoff, like where it's like a simple lifestyle spinoff where they go to a small town and they try to like live there, acclimate, or I don't know what it is entirely, but it's similar to the simple life with the two of them. And I think that was originally slated for Peacock, but I think it's actually going to end up airing on Bravo instead, from the rumors that I've heard. And again, all of this is unconfirmed. It's either my speculation or just a roundup of all the rumors that are out there right now. So don't quote me on any of this stuff, but this is just what's being talked about. And it seems like this info seems to be a little more solid in comparison to other rumors about RHONY that have come out in the past, which is why I never really talked about it, because I was like, let's wait until there's something that's a little more solidified. But it seems like they're happy with the Lu and Sonja spinoff. And I actually think it's an interesting model if they do take it to Peacock, because if we move to Peacock, similar to like Ultimate Girls Trip, right, it's a concept that we can use interchangeably in the future, which is Housewives in general, right? We did it with Lu and Sonja, where it's like Housewives in the Wild, Housewives in the Island, baby. And so I think it's something that we can probably do in the future. Like, maybe take Giselle and what's her name? Robin. Take Giselle and Robin to do a similar concept where you kind of just take a housewife duo, take them out of their element, put them in a different element, and see what their natural response and reaction are, and kind of make it fun and lighthearted with a little bit of levity. You know, maybe we do one with like Oh my God, could you imagine if we did one with Brandy Glanville and like Kelly Dodd, like two chaotic housewives, and we throw them into some unprecedented territory? That would be fun. So I can see them taking that concept and kind of doing that similar to like what they're doing with Ultimate Girls Trip, where they're taking different housewives and putting them in a similar environment and just kind of being like, let's see what happens. So hopefully it's not just a solely Lu and Sonja spinoff, because I would like to see other housewives in this situation as well. But we'll have to see what BravoCon brings. They have to make some sort of big announcement at BravoCon. And like I said, RHONY just seems like the most natural thing for them to talk about.